Don't tell your mother. Kiss one another. Die for each other. We're cool for the summer. So, what's up, guys? In this video, I basically just kind of wanted to talk about something that basically has hit pretty close to home, and plus keeping with the whole thing that I have promised that I was going to try and do some videos that do concern the NorCal area at least from time to time. Now, what I'm about ready to say is probably going to be seen as hypocritical by some. Some may, especially in my own ideological camp, may disagree with me, and I may find that I will be chastised for it as well, and probably called white colonizer, imperialist, you know, all kinds of other BS and stuff like that, above all being called a hypocrite for what I'm about ready to say. But it needs to be said. And these, again, are my own personal viewpoints. Perhaps they will change at a future date. But essentially, my opinion, when it comes down to the issue, I've spoken, I think, on the issue before, on the issue when they talk about the changing of the name of the Washington Redskins, because it's, you know, and I will be the first to admit that, yes, do I find that the term Redskin to be a little derogatory? Yes, I do. At the same time, I also view the whole thing as it's a football team. It's a bourgeois entity. And, you know, if we're going to do anything, we should smash the bourgeois entity, or at the very least make it so that sports is actually a thing that's, you know, can be enjoyed and is not a corporate shill of a big entertainment monopoly, or a sports entertainment monopoly. And that, of course, being Washington Redskins under the umbrella of the National Football League. But yeah, it's the whole fact that the point is it's a damn fucking sports team, and, you know, I don't really see what changing the name really does to challenge any sort of bourgeois system. I don't see what changing the name really does, other than to make a few other people feel happy. And ultimately, these people that are bitching, you know, the people that are bitching over the Washington Redskins name, they're not doing really anything to contribute to challenge the status quo or to do anything, really. They're just bitchy because of a term that, yes, is derogatory, but it's the name of a sports team, and it's nothing more than a distraction from the real issues of fighting against racial inequality. So, I mean, it is a very small thing in comparison to a whole bunch of other BS that is going on in this country. You know, I'm not trying to take away from Native Americans' plight, or the fact that this government, this country, basically, you know, raped their land and their women, and basically genocidally murdered 100 million people. I'm not denying that, and I'm not taking away from that. I'm just saying that this, you know, reformist, social justice warrior, liberal BS of political correctness and trying to do this, sort of changing of certain names because it offends somebody. It's bourgeois bullcrap. And that's all it fucking is. You know? And yes, there are certain terms I don't like either, but I'm more focused on the bigger issue and not trying to rename things. So, because if I was just in the business of trying to rename things, then I would basically be out marching saying, well, let's change the name of the, you know, the U.S., you know, let's basically change the name of the United States to fascist murdering pigs. You know, in other words, you kind of see where I'm going with it. It doesn't really do a damn bit of difference, a damn bit of good, to sit around bitching, oh, I don't like the name of this team. And this leads me into what my main topic is about. Recently, in Fairfield, California, a high school, and keep in mind, this high school has been around since about the 1880s, 1890s, or something like that. It is one of the oldest schools, not only in the area, within the Bay Area, within NorCal, it's one of the oldest schools in the state. And it was, you know, one of the very first, like, you know, secondary education sort of schools. It was one of the first, like, major high schools in this area. It was named after a man named, fucking forget his first name, but his name, last name was Armio. And Armio was a big, now, you also have to keep in mind that Armio was himself a friggin' imperialist. At the same time, this school was named after, it was named after. The area that surrounds basically what is Solano County, and I'll get to where that name came from in a minute, was originally land of a lot of the area of along the, primarily along the North Bay in what is today Napa, Solano, Yolo, and even parts of, I think, Sacramento counties, and even parts of Lake County, actually. But a lot of these areas here along in Northern California were the Indian tribes, the Native American tribes that lived here were Patlins. And one of the Native American tribes that happened to roam this particular area were called the Susunis. Hence where the town of Susun City comes from. The town of Susun bears the name of the Native American tribe. One of the men that was chief of this tribe was a man named Samyeto, also known as Chief Solano. A school in this area is named after Samyeto, and his Christianized name, Solano, is the name of this county. The county, a school, bear his name. A statue commemorating this man is in the town of Fairfield, California. And the name of a town, of an entire town, is named after his tribe. And the fact that Armio High School has now come under fire from these social justice warrior groups who are, you know, trying to basically have the mascot changed and essentially have the name of its mascot and its athletic department, that it is held for over a century. Yes, is the term Indian, you know, inaccurate? Yes, the term Indian is inaccurate on a lot of levels, considering that the term Indian was a word used to describe the natives of the West Indies, what we now call today, you know, Hispaniola or Dominican Republic and Haiti and those areas. You know, it was because at the time, Spanish explorers thought that they had reached India, hence the term Indies and Indian. That was a cultural misappropriation, and that was a cultural mistake, and that was just in general the name that stuck due to white colonizer thinking and, well, ignorance. Now, far be it from me, and of course, I'm going to be, you know, let me just put it this way. Far be it from me to, you know, end up sounding like I'm trying to go off, you know, kind of go down this route myself, and forgive me if I do sound hypocritical, but even though it is an inaccurate term, do I think it's an offensive term? Not necessarily. Do I think that it's a politically incorrect term? Yes. Do I think that it is an inaccurate term? Without a doubt. But at the same time, if we are going to change some name of the school's mascot, at least change it to something that is more accurate, such as the Armio Natives. But could we please keep the symbol and the heritage and the history of this, not only this city, but the county? Why get rid of a symbol that is doing no harm to anybody? It is not doing mental harm, it is not doing physical harm, it is not doing emotional harm. There is no reason to get all reformist and petty bourgeois over a fucking mascot, over a fucking name, when it doesn't accomplish anything. It doesn't challenge the fucking status quo. It doesn't challenge capitalism, and it doesn't challenge the freaking white colonizer, you know, and white supremacy of the United States. It's like, oh, wonderful, you might change a name. It doesn't do a damn thing to actually challenge the system that has caused this whole, you know, debacle in the first place. If you want to establish real change, then be the driving force for it. Don't go out bitching, "Oh, I don't like the name." Fuck you. Then fucking go do something that actually means something. And if we're going to, and I will concede the idea that if we want to change the name, change it to the Armio Natives. That is more accurate. Because Native American is a is technically an accurate term. Or First Nations people, if you're referring to those in Canada. But essentially, this is Native, you know, this was a city, a county, that has a strong history and heritage of Native American culture. You know, And frankly, I find it even more offensive that, you know, that there is this... Now, I'm not going to go that route, because... Yeah, I'm not even going to get into that. I just think that the whole idea that no one has attempted to try to contact, you know, to track down and contact any possible living descendants of Semieto, or any possible living descendants of someone who was a Patwin or a Susuni. Now, this is coming from a more statewide and national group of so-called Native American activists who are trying to align themselves with the ACLU. And normally, there are a lot of things that I will side with the ACLU on. There are times, though, when I think the ACLU basically will also just jump to the defense of just about anything as long as it somehow benefits them. Because let's be honest, the ACLU is still petty bourgeois. And it's still, you know, it is still a friggin' liberal group that, you know, is always trying to fight for some sort of social justice. And there are times when they take that social justice, you know, social liberal friggin', you know, petty bourgeois activism to the point where it is social justice warrior-like. And, you know, this warmongering sort of mentality, you know, beating the drums, as it was. And the fact that they're... Yeah, it's not that I don't understand the issue going on here. What I don't understand is why all of a sudden this is becoming an issue, much like the issue with the... The Washington Redskins issue was actually broiling for some time, but came to a fiery head last year, and for the most part has just died out because no one cares about it anymore. It received a little bit of, you know, friggin' notoriety for a while, and yes, they are still continuing that fight, but most people, including a lot of Native Americans that I've talked to, or Native Americans that I've even found, who either don't really fucking care, or just think that it's a bunch of people trying to get their 15 minutes of fame. And I think this is a similar situation, especially considering that there was nothing going wrong up until like a few days ago, and then all of a sudden this one group of people just start saying, well, we don't like the name and we want it to be changed. And it took you this fucking long to do it. And why now? Why not 5 years? Why did you not start this like 5 years ago or 10 years ago? Why didn't you start, or better yet, why, you know, if you were waiting that long, why not have waited 5 more years? You know, what suddenly made now suddenly this opportunity? Oh, because the people were doing that because of the Washington Redskins thing, and you thought that you could, you know, ride the coattails of that? I'm sorry, I just kind of find the whole idea to be really just pretty much full of coincidences, and I'm not really one that believes in coincidences. Or at least does not like to subscribe to a lot of coincidences. I prefer to look through actual issues and try to find a more rationale sort of thing to it. So, yeah, I really, like I say, I understand in some ways the whole issue about, you know, why you might feel uncomfortable with the term Indian. And I do, too, believe that if we're going to do anything, could we change the name to just Natives? Because that would definitely, because then you're not really, I think that's a reasonable compromise, because then you're still paying homage to the heritage and history and of the Native American tribes that roamed this great territory, and you're not and then it's not really stepping on toes on either side. I think it's a reasonable compromise. And as far as the symbol of this high school, again, it's the same thing as the Redskins football national football team. It's just a sport. It's just a team. It's just sports. Who cares? Really, it's there's far more better and bigger and better issues and far more things in challenging the racial inequality in this country than simply changing the name of an athletic department. It's ridiculous. And it's also the fact that the same group of people changed the name of the Vallejo Apaches to the Vallejo Redhawks, when I really don't understand what was wrong with the term Apache, considering that is the name of a Native American tribe. Is that tribe technically from California? No, but there are people that live here that are Apaches. One of my friends is part Apache. And you know what this friend of mine who's part Apache says about this whole issue with the Armio thing? She thinks it's retarded. Her mother, who is also Native American, thinks it's retarded. So, I don't really understand why people... I mean, you know, it's... Again, it comes down to this whole thing that I think it's just a few people looking for... It's people looking for something to get offended about, and it's political correctness. And I hate to personally say it, but... a lot of forms of political correctness are just basically petty bourgeois, and they are in, you know, and I guess the modern term, it is social justice warrior mongering, but essentially a lot of political correctness is just essentially petty bourgeois, and it doesn't really accomplish anything. It's just, you know, people that look to get offended over something. It's like, if you get offended over something, wonderful. Go fucking bitch and whine and complain like everybody other troll on the internet. But if you're actually serious about enacting radical change, actually go out and be willing to fight real issues of racial inequality, because changing the name of a sports team or an athletic department doesn't really do jack diddly. And of course, like I said, I expect there to be a bunch of people out there to criticize me, especially in my own camp and especially from people on the other side of the spectrum who will probably come out and say, well, you're a hypocrite. You don't like the name of the... you don't like the Confederate flag, because of the heritage and hate... you know, the heritage and history thing, but you're claiming heritage and history of your town over, you know, over this thing. Yeah, I am. Because you know why? There's a difference. It's heritage... it's a heritage of hate when it concerns the Confederate flag in the South. I don't care if people don't like that idea, but it is. It's not heritage or hate, it's a heritage of hate. The difference between that and this is that this is actually concerning the heritage and history of a town, moreover a region, that was run by Native America, that once was home, was the home of Native American tribes. Yes, there was issues of racial injustice, genocide of a people, imperialism, white colonizer crap, all kinds of stuff that occurred along with it. But the name of the county, the name of a town, and the name of a school, all basically paying homage to a great man, a great Native American man, and to the tribe that he commanded. I think trying to basically change the name of an athletic department, you know, is almost like they're trying to erase some sort of history and heritage of this area. I think, to be quite honest, I find it offensive myself, because I find it to be an actual insult to the memory of Chief Sam Yeto and to the Susuni Patwin Native American tribe. I think it is absolutely insensitive. But of course, I'm just some white person on the internet that is opposed to what's going on. So of course I must be a white colonizer. I must have this white colonizer mentality. I must be this great hypocrite, you know, towards my ideology and my viewpoints. I must be this great hypocrite because I'm, you know, don't agree with this, yet I'm opposed to, you know, something else where I, you know, that I don't agree is about heritage and history. You know, I just think it's, yeah, so basically, yeah, I expect to have the full brunt of criticisms, claims of hypocrisy, claims that I'm reactionary, and all that sort of crap. And you know what? If you don't like it, blow me. I don't care. I really don't. I just am here to formally express an opinion. I really think that it's nothing more than a petty bourgeois distraction. And I say that from a Marxist perspective. I literally believe that this is a petty bourgeois distraction to divert attention away from the real causes, the real issues of, you know, what, you know, of the actual of racial inequality. It's just a petty, you know, it really is. It's a petty distraction away from, you know, fighting for the real issues. Because people aren't willing, and that's the problem in the first world, is that people are not willing to do revolution. They're not willing to actually fight for real, and this is essentially, they're not willing to fight for real fucking issues anymore. They're all about, you know, this reformist, social democratic, you know, they're for the radical change that they want. They basically do this, you know, reformist social democratic BS at best, and, you know, and on the other side of that is just this petty, you know, bourgeois liberal bullcrap. I don't like this and that, and we need to change this because that term is racist. You know, and it's like, again, are there terms that are racist? Yes. Are there terms that are derogatory? Yes. Are there terms that are just also plain just inaccurate? Yes. But if we spend too much time wishy-washying around this crap, then we're not really focusing our time, we're not then focusing as much time and effort on the real issues, like the real issues of racial inequality. I just think it's complete BS. You know, and I think that this political that some versions of political correctness are not bad. Political correctness in general is a social liberal concept. It's a social justice concept. And to be quite blunt with it, political correctness is not revolutionary. I'm not saying it's reactionary. In some cases, it can be if pushed to a fucking extreme, but it is not revolutionary. At most, political correctness is some reformist liberal BS. So, that's where I stand on this. That's where I stand on the Armio athletic mascot debacle. And that's where I really stand on this PC crap. That's where I stand on it. And like I said, if you don't like my opinion, blow me. You know, you're free to disagree with me. You're free to debate me in an intellectual conversation and try to sway my opinion. But if all you're going to do is criticize me, call me a hypocrite, call me a white colonizer, call me racist, call me a reactionary, blow me. Fucking suck my cock, you motherfucking assholes. Because I'm not responding to that sort of, ostentatious asininity. I'm not going to respond to, a bunch of ad hominem attacks. I'm not. But I will respond to those that are prepared to debate me in an intellectual conversation. Those are the people that you will see me responding to in the comments. Everybody else, piss off. I'm NorCal Nick, leader of the revolutionist movement, and this has been NorCal Corner. Peace.